Let's start by localizing your bot profile file. Go to your Steam folder, then Steam apps, Common, Counter-Strike GO, and CSGO. I have a couple of profiles, but the only one that matters here is botprofile.db. First, we have the default profile. Those stats are given to every bot and then they are being changed by templates and data written directly under a bot. The only thing that you should really care about here are look angle values. By default, they are shared between all bots, but of course, there is nothing that stops you from adding them to a weapon or class profile. I'm not really sure how each number affects bot aim, so you will need to experiment with them to get best results for your bots. I'm using these values. Just remember to keep all of default values, even if you're going to change them later in the configs, as lacking one of them might completely break your bots. Next up, we have weapon templates. Here you have a list of weapons that bot prefers, from his most desired gun to least desired one. If he'll have a chance to buy a better gun from this list, or if he's holding a weapon that isn't listed here, he will instantly drop it and buy a new one. Remember that only 3 to 5 weapons are supported during buy time. Rest of them only matters if he walks over a gun during gameplay. And weapon replacements like revolver or M4A1S don't work here. They are either ignored or replaced with standard weapon types. Some people try to add vests or pistols to this list and you shouldn't do it. Why? Because the first weapon on the list changes the item pool he's going to check. For an example, adding a deagle is going to make him only check pistols and then change to weapon preference none. And if you're going to place it on any other position, it will just be ignored. Also, for some reason Valve decided that during buy time bots are not going to their weapon profile until they will find a weapon matching their team, and instead they are emulating pressing a button on the buy menu. To better understand this, I will use Rifle T as an example. A Rifle T bot on Counter-Terrorist team is going to buy and use M4A4, but during buy time the only weapon he checks at first is AK-47. And here comes the reason why you need to have weapons from both teams in your weapon template and close to each other. Because if we're going to remove M4A4 from this weapon profile, a Rifle T-bot on Counter-Terrorist team is going to buy an M4, because he has an AK-47 at the top, but he's instantly going to drop it and go for Famas, since M4 isn't anywhere in his template. I know it's pretty hard to understand, so in case you still have no idea what I'm talking about, then in short, if you have a team variant of a gun like AK or Mag 7, then make sure the other team version is directly above it or below it. Otherwise, bot might end up buying lots of guns and dropping them on the floor. Those templates have all other stats except look angle values saved. Most of them are pretty much self-explanatory. Aim focus values are explained in the comments back in the default values, and rank and cost options are left over from condition 0. Skill is a number between 0 and 100 that makes bots act smarter. For an example, bot with skill 0 is going to run and gun or just stand like an idiot while firing, only use his primary and other stuff like that. But remember, skill amount does not affect speed or accuracy of his aim. Aggression is changing playstyle of bots. High amount of aggression is going to make them rush more, but also be a bit more lethal while fighting multiple enemies. Low values are going to encourage camping and retreating. At the end, we have each individual bot listed with his skill level, weapon profile, skin and voice pitch. And of course, skin and voice are leftovers from source. Adding any kind of template or bot is really simple. You can just make a copy of a bot or template you want to add and then change its name and stats. Adding a bot without weapon profile is going to change his weapon preference to none, and that will result in completely random buys and ignoring weapons on ground. And adding a bot without a difficulty level template is going to give him stats from defaults. If you have any trouble setting up your own bot profile or just want to check out the one I've made, just go into the link in the description and download it from Gamebanana. I've tried to make bots buy weapons that are useful in competitive while still keeping it fun and varied. I hope you will like it and have fun!